Hey guys, so in this video I'm demonstrating how I drew these oranges in soft pastels. The paper that I use this time is UArt 600. It's a sanded paper. It's one of my favorites to use as far as pastel paintings goes. For the underpainting, I'm using Derwent Inktense. These are blocks that are actually water-soluble ink, so you can lay them down like you do pastels for your first layer. They feel a little waxy going on, but as soon as you put water over them, they turn into water-soluble ink. So they're really good for underpainting for pastels and getting some bright, vibrant colors underneath your pastels. I didn't really go with anything like complimentary, or there was no rhyme or reason to the underpainting that I made here. I just wanted something that would give a little bit of a pop underneath my pastel painting. And you'll see I have to come over a couple times because I didn't really lay down the Inktense heavily. You could put a heavier layer of Inktense before adding water so you won't have to add multiple layers. I started out with like a bluish gray for that top part there, but I decided I didn't end up liking that in the end. And you'll see me change it a couple times as things go on. On the left side of the screen, you can see the color chart that I made for my Inktense. That is something that I wrote out all of the names of the Inktense blocks that I got. I got the set of 72. And then I used my paintbrush, took a little bit of water, and placed it on watercolor paper to give myself a good idea of what the Inktense blocks look like when they're activated with water. They don't look exactly like you would think they would, those and the pencils that Inktense comes in. It's good to make those little color charts whenever you get a new material like that, just so you have a good idea of what you're working with. So you can see me start to layer soft pastels on top of my now dry underpainting. Since I'm drawing oranges, I'm starting out with some bold oranges and I'm going to come on top with some lighter values. I'm not using my fingers to blend for the majority of this. I'm using the pastels themselves to blend. And this will help you get a little more of an impressionistic look. I'm trying to keep things loose as I go along, so I'm not making many strokes as far as the different colors goes. I'll lay a little bit of one value, then the next value, then the next, until it looks a little bit realistic, but not super realistic. And I'm going to save my brightest values for the very last. Using some dark purples to add a little bit of shadow underneath and on top of the oranges. There's really no rhyme or reason to anything that I'm doing here. Just whatever I feel like will look good at the time. One of the things that's great about the sanded paper is that you can get that really rough look there without too much effort. But again, I'm taking care not to blend the pastels with my fingers. I'm blending only with the actual blocks of pastels themselves. And making sure that I at least get my values correct. I'm not really aiming for my colors being exact to the photo. I am aiming more that my values are what they're supposed to be. My darks are dark enough, my lights are light enough. That will help it look a little more realistic, even though I'm not going for super realism here. And just kind of playing around with the shadows in the background until they look what I feel is good. What you think is good may be a little different. This was just a practice piece, really. Something a little fun to do in between more detailed works. I like to do those once in a while to loosen up a little bit and have a little fun. And here is my finished piece. If you create something similar to this, please tag me in the comments. I would love to see what you're doing. And let me know if you have any questions. Thanks!